Okay. Last time we started so-called connected spaces, right? We say a pair of disjoint open sets form a separation for the space X if their union is equal to X, right? So U V has to be open, disjoint, and union is equal to X. In this case, we say that the pair UV forms a separation for X, and we also say that X is disconnected. And if X is not disconnected, in other words, if X has no separation, then we say that X is connected, bağlantılı diyoruz. Peki bir başka formülasyon da şuydu. Bir uzayın connected olmaması. A space is connected if and only if. The only subsets which are both open and closed are the empty set and X itself. Of course here, if U and V are, if they form a separation for X, then since they are disjoint and they are both open, and their complements are each other. Therefore, they are also both closed. So if X has a separation, then there are some subsets which are neither empty set and X itself, and they are both closed and open. So if they are connected, then there should be no such subset except empty set and X itself. That was observation, and then we had stated connectedness for a subspace, an equivalent formulation of connectedness for a subspace, and we said that a subspace for a subspace, a separation means the following: a separation is a disjoint non-empty pair of sets whose union is Y, and neither of which contains a limit point of the other one. Okay, so that's an equivalent statement for a separation. Now let's prove this. First, suppose that A and B form a separation for Y. Well, this means Y is the union of these. A and B are disjoint, and AB are open in Y. Well, since they are open in Y and their union is equal to Y, they are complements of each other. Thus, A and B are closed in Y, right? Well, since they are closed, so A is equal to then A closure intersection Y. Right? Because since it is closed, its closure in Y is just, we know that closure of A in Y is equal to, so if I write, for example, like this, closure of A in Y, I know that this is equal to A. But on the other hand, we know that closure in Y is nothing but the closure in X intersection with Y. Right? Therefore, A is equal to A closure intersection Y, where A closure means just the closure in X, usual closure. But then this means, and thus, empty set, which is A union B, and that is just what? A closure intersection B. Okay. So this means what? This means hence B contains no limit point of A. Well, of course, similarly, the other way around, similarly, right? There is no distinction between A and B in this context. Similarly, this is empty. A intersection B closure is empty, and thus A contains no limit point of B. Okay. Well, this is one direction. Now, for the other direction, for the converse, A and B are disjoint subsets of Y, so that neither of which contains the limit point of the other. This means A closure intersection B is empty, and A intersection B closure is empty. But then, what do we have? Then, okay, B is equal to X minus A closure intersection Y, right? Because A closure and B doesn't intersect, therefore B is just equals to this guy, right? And I know that A closure is closed in X, therefore X minus A is open in X, therefore this intersection is open in Y. Right, so that B is open in Y, since X minus A closure is open in X. Similarly, A is just X minus B closure intersection Y is open in Y also. So what we have seen is then A and B are disjoint subsets of Y, so that they don't contain any limit point of the other one. And by assumption, of course, their union is, I didn't write it here, but so that and A union B is Y, right? So that's also part of the assumption. And what we have seen now, A and B are also open in Y. Follows then A and B, right, they form a separation for the subspace Y because they are open subsets of Y, they are disjoint and their union is equal to Y. So they form a separation. So this finishes the proof. Okay. Okay. Let's see some examples of connected and disconnected spaces. One example is this. So X is the two-point set. Let's say AB, and tau is the indiscrete topology, empty set, and X itself. Well, this is, although it contains just two points and they are not the same, they are different points. This space is connected since there is no separation, right? There is no separation for X. There are not even non-empty open sets, other than empty set and X, right? What else? Okay, why is this gadget? Is a subspace of R standard. This is disconnected. Disconnected. Why is that? Since minus 1, 0, and 0, 1 are disjoint subsets, and neither one of them contains a limit point of the other, right? So let, for example, A to be minus 1, 0, and B is 0, minus 1. These are both open and closed subsets of Y, right? You see that A closure is equal to what? What is this? This is just minus 1, 0, intersection Y, which is just again A. And B closure is just 0, 1. So I take closure in R and then intersect with Y. I take closure in R, intersect with Y. So this is again 0, 1, which is just B. So they are both closed, and since they are complements of each other, since Y is A union B and A intersection B is empty, they are also both open. So I have two disjoint open sets whose union is equal to Y. Thus, Y is disconnected. Actually, I could just use the lemma directly, right, and say that Y is connected easily. Yeah. Note that closure was already A union the limit points, okay? So limit points are in the closure. Okay. You're right. Disconnected. They form a separation. Sorry. Okay. Q as a subset of R standard is disconnected. Connected subset or subspace. Why is that? Well, because I can write Q as what? You see, this is just the open interval in R intersected with Q. So this is an open set in Q, right? This is open in Q. Union two plus infinity intersection Q. This is another open set in Q. And they are both non-empty and they are disjoint, right? Is a disjoint union and they are both non-empty and they are both non-empty. Oops. Thus, Q is disconnected. Okay. Okay. This subset, let's say x comma y, such that y equals 0 or x is positive and y equals 1 over x. This is also is disconnected. Why is that? Let's see. So this is the set of y equals 0. So I consider pairs where y is 0. Well, that is just the x-axis, right? So y equals 0. Or should I write y equals 0? And what about this one? It is the one branch of the hyperbola y equals 1 over x for x is positive. So it is just this okay piece. So x is positive, y equals 1 over x. Well, visually one can see that this is a disconnected space, but formally we have to write down a separation for this. How can we write down a separation for this? Well, we can write down a separation for this as follows. Let me draw another curve here, this one. What is this? This is x is positive and y equals 1 over 2x. Okay. 1 over 2x. Well, then this curve separates the plane into two pieces. One piece is this side, the below of this red one, where y is less than 1 over 2x. For example, origin is here. 0 is, okay, 0 is not a good example, but okay, let's say, something like this. So y is 0 No, oh. Yeah, that doesn't work. Sorry. Biraz daha dikkatli olmam lazım. Şöyle diyeyim, şöyle diyeyim. Şöyle diyelim, U şu olsun, U şu subset olsun, X virgül Y'ler öyle ki ha, Y pozitif, Y pozitif. V de şu olsun. X virgül Y'ler öyle ki ya evet X negatif ya da x pozitif ama y 1 bölü 2x'ten küçük. Yani mesela şu nokta x pozitif ama y'si 1 bölü 2'den küçük. Evet. Şimdi U and V are open subsets of R2. Okay. Yes. Bir dakika ama. Bu iyi bir fikir değil. Şunu da aynı şekilde yapmam lazım. Şimdi bu kırmızı eğrinin altını yazmak istiyorum. O nedir? X virgül Y'ler. Öyle ki yok. X pozitif. X pozitif. And Y büyüktür 1 bölü 2x. Bu kırmızı eğrinin üst kısmı. So, U is the upper part of this red curve. So, X is positive and Y is greater than 1 over 2x. And V is the lower part of this red curve. What is that? It is either the set of points where x is negative. Actually, I should include also this, right? X could be zero, including the y-axis, or x is positive and y is less than 1 over 2x. Okay. These are open subsets of R2. One of them is above the red curve, the other one is the below the red curve, right? And U intersection X is it is just X comma Y. X is positive. And y equals 1 over x. And v intersection x is just x comma y. And it is the other piece. Evet. Bir saniye. Şimdi U'da tamam. V dediğimiz şey aslında V'yi şöyle alsam daha iyi. Hiç buna gerek yok. V'yi şöyle alalım. V eşittir. R2 eksi U'nun closure'ı. Yani bu da ne demek? U'nun closure'ı şu. X virgül Y'ler. Şimdi closure'ını aldığın zaman bu büyük eşit olacak. Bu da büyük eşit olacak. Onun komplemanını alırsan yani ya x negatif or y küçüktür 1 bölü 2x. Sanki böyle daha düzgün gibi oldu. U'nun closure'ı nedir? U'nun closure'ı X'in sıfır olduğu yerler ve Y'nin büyük eşit 1 bölü X olduğu yerler. Onun Yok, closure'ında evet. Gerçi biraz daha dikkatli olmak lazım. U'nun closure'ı şey değil gibi. Şimdi U'nun closure'ı nedir? U'nun closure'ı x virgül y'ler. Şimdi x pozitif olacak. Y'de 1 bölü x'ten 2x'ten büyük eşit. Closure'ında sanki U'nun closure'ı şu. Yani x'in sıfır olma ihtimali yok yine de. Closure'ı bu. Evet. Yani V'yi de R2 eksi U'nun closure alacağız. O zaman burası da x'in sıfır olduğu yer olacak. Yok, y'nin sıfır olduğu yer miydi? Yani U'nun closure'ı kırmızının üst kısmı, kırmızı eğriyi içeriyor. Dışı da Kırmızının alt kısmı. Geri kalan her şey. Yani sanırım böyle. Siz yine bir düşünün bunu da sanırım orada sorun yok. Şimdi bir lema daha var. If the sets C and D form a separation, of a space X and if Y is a connected subspace then Y lies entirely either either C or D. Yani X'in bir separation varsa şöyle yazıyoruz. C ve D X içinde open subsets. C boş küme değil. D is not empty and C intersection D is empty. And Y is a connected subset. Well, if of course Y intersects both with D and C, if C intersection Y is not empty and D intersection Y is not empty, then of course I could write this. Y is the union of this intersection, which are both open in Y because C and D are open in X. And this is the disjoint union because C and D are disjoint. Therefore, this would be a separation, right? Would be a separation for the subspace, Y. But Y is connected, however, Y is connected, therefore it has no separation, and thus either this one is empty or this one is empty. However, C and D are complements of each other. Finally, X is just C union D, right? And hence, C intersection Y empty means Y is in D, right? It is in the complement of C. Complement of C is just D. Or C intersection no. D intersection Y would be empty and this would imply Y is in C. So we see that if Y is connected then Y either lies in C or D. Okay? This is something we use a lot actually whenever we have an connectedness argument, we use such reasoning, I mean such argument. There are some more easy observations. Let me just continue. Another observation. We are trying to get examples of connected spaces. Okay. One example is obtained via the following theorem. The union of a collection of connected subspaces subspaces of X that have a point in common is connected. Okay, so this means what? I have a collection of subsets. Okay, collection of connected subspaces, subspaces. And what we know is that their union is not empty. So by assumption, this intersection is not empty. So let x0 be a point in this intersection, okay, since it is not empty. All right. Okay, now for a separation of a subspace, we know that there should be a separation for the bigger space and intersection of that separation with this subspace would give, should they give a separation for this subspace. So if let's say, okay, so let Y be this union. Okay, our aim is to show that. Must show Y is connected. Well, to show Y is connected, so let C union D be a separation for Y. Okay. Well, Y is x0 is a point in this intersection, so x0 is a point in Y. Since x0 is a point in C, which is Y, without loss of generality, we may assume that. Assume that this point x0 belongs to, let's say, C, right? Well, we use the previous lemma now. Since each A alpha is connected, subspace of Y, and C union D is a separation for Y, A alpha is contained in C or D, right? But this point x0 lies in C already, and it's a point of a0. However, since x0 is in C intersection A alpha, it's also point of A alpha, we see that A alpha is a subset of C. But alpha is just an arbitrary index, right? So this is true for any alpha, right? So each A alpha lies in C, hence their union Y, which is the union of A alphas, is a subset of C. And this is a contradiction. Is a contradiction. Niye contradiction olsun? Yok, contradiction değil. Tamam. Dolayısıyla bunu görmüş olduk. Ha tamam. Contradiction çünkü separation demiştik. A contradiction. Contradiction. Since bu durumda D is empty. Right? I have Y equals C union D. C and D are disjoint open subsets of Y, but I see that Y is already contained in C. Therefore, there is no point in Y which lies in D, right? All of the points of Y lies in C. Therefore, that's a contradiction. And the reason we had a contradiction is that I assumed here Y has a separation, right? Thus, Y has no separation. Okay. And this proves the result. Sorusu olan var mı buraya kadar? Yani elinizde connected setler varsa ve bunların da ortak bir noktası varsa, hepsinin ortak bir noktası varsa, o zaman bunların union'u da doğrudan connected bir subspace oluyor. Peki, bir başka sonuç yine connected space elde etmenin bir yolu. Let A be a connected subspace of, sorry, subspace of X if A is in B and B is in A closure, then B is also connected. Okay. So this means what? If you have a connected subspace, anything between that subspace and its closure is connected. Okay. And the proof is easy. So, okay, let B equals C union D, C union D be a separation, separation for B. Okay, separation for B. So I assume that B is disconnected and B has a separation. A is contained in B. Since A is a subspace, is a connected subspace, right? Connected subspace. Well, A is a connected subspace of X, but it's also a connected subspace of B because P is a subspace of X also, right? So I can say that A is a connected subspace of B. And this is the separation. So this means by the above lemma, değil mi? O lemmamız ne diyordu? If a space is a separation, then any connected subspace lies either in C or D. So we have exactly the same, you know, situation here. B is a space, it is a separation, and A is a subspace which is connected. So by the above lemma, A is either in C or A is in D. Well, since C, D form a separation for B, they are both open and closed in B. Note that C and D are both closed and open in B. In particular, C is a closed subset. So A, which is in A closure, also lies in C. But then okay. Yeah, which implies B is a subset of C because A closure contains B. Therefore, if A closure is in C, then B is in C. But this is again a contradiction because, you know, C union D is a separation for B means both of them, C and D, are both non-empty, but this implies D empty, okay? A contradiction. Neye? Efendim? Bir dakika. Nereye itiraz ettin sen? Şu soğudan sonraki şey mi? Bir dakika. Şimdi C ve D B'nin içinde closed'lar. Bir dakika bakayım. Ha, bir tane Tamam, şöyle diyeyim, şöyle diyeyim. Evet, orada biraz daha dikkatli olmam lazım. Şimdi anladım. Şimdi şunu biliyoruz. A ya C'nin içinde ya D'nin içinde, değil mi? Diyelim ki şey olsun. If A is in C, then A closure is in C closure. Okay. Ama şunu da biliyorum. Bu separation olduğuna göre since C closure and D are disjoint, hani separations da birinin closure'ıyla biri diğerine limit point'ini içeremiyor. Böyle. Dolayısıyla da buradan şey söyleyebilirim tekrar. Bir dakika. Şimdi A'nın closure'ı yani şu var sonuçta B A'nın closure'ının içinde olduğuna göre ve böyle olduğuna göre since and B de A'nın closure'ında olduğuna göre we see that B ile D'nin kesişimi de boş küme. Ama bu da contradiction. Çünkü bu bir separation'da. Evet. Sanırım tamam. Bir başka connected space örneği üretme yolu da sürekli fonksiyonlar. The image bunu bir dahaki ders yapalım. Sorry.